Ever wonder what the inside of your ear canal looks like? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you what you should see in a normal ear canal and a few things you shouldn't. Coming up. This video is sponsored by Natus, formerly Otometrics, the preferred diagnostic equipment supplier of Dr. Cliff AUD. Since the 1950s, Otometrics has been one of the most innovative manufacturers of hearing aid fitting equipment and diagnostic hearing and balance equipment in the industry. When it comes to testing and treating my patients, I only want to work with the best. This is why I use Natus in my clinic. Chances are you've had doctors looking inside of your ear canals for years, basically any time that you go in for a routine checkup. And they typically grab their otoscope, take a look inside of your ears, and either say, everything looks fine here, or they don't tell you anything at all, and then they move on. But what is it that they're looking for? Well, luckily for you, I have my video otoscope, so I can show you everything you want to see inside of an ear canal, and then some things that you really don't want to see inside of an ear canal. So make sure that you get your popcorn ready and enjoy the show, unless that is you have a really sensitive stomach. Okay, so when performing otoscopy, you want to make sure that you have a really high quality otoscope that gives you a really good visual of the ear canal and of the eardrum. Now, I love my Welsh Allyn otoscope, but the problem is that it doesn't allow my patients to see what I see, and since I want my patients to have a really good understanding of everything that's going on with their ears and their hearing, it really requires the use of a video otoscope. When I first started my clinic, I attempted to use a cheaper Firefly otoscope, but the problem is its field of view was too small, which made it nearly impossible to get the proper perspective of what I was looking at, and even more difficult for my patients, which kind of defeats the purpose. So I decided to step up my game to a higher quality video otoscope, the Aurical Otocam300, which gives a much larger field of view and the ability to autofocus, allowing me and my patients to gain proper perspective, allowing us to see exactly what's going on inside of their ears. When it comes to performing otoscopy, we're looking for a few different things. First, we want to see a fully developed pinna without any signs of rash or infection. Then, upon inserting the otoscope into the ear canal, we should see some cerumen, also known as earwax, lining the ear canal, but not so much that it obstructs our view of the tympanic membrane, which is also known as the eardrum. We also shouldn't see any foreign bodies in the ear canal, such as cotton left over from a Q-tip, or the always popular cockroach that you see in other YouTube videos. When visualizing the eardrum specifically, we should see several things. First is a translucent membrane that is almost see-through. You should see an umbo, which is the central most inverted portion of the eardrum, the annular ligament, which attaches the eardrum to the ear canal, the manubrium of the malleus, the first of the three middle ear ossicle bones, and the cone of light, which is a reflection of my otoscope light. Now, this is for a normal ear canal if everything goes to plan. But every once in a while, we get something out of the ordinary, and I'm going to use my video otoscope to show you a few of these things. Let's take a look inside of the ear of a patient who was recently referred by her primary care physician for impacted earwax. You can see that this individual has a big wall of earwax in her ear canal. Cerumen, the technical term for earwax, can cause hearing loss if it completely blocks the ear canal. However, in this patient's case, it looks like there is a small space for sound to pass through. Wax like this is relatively easy to remove, but it is even easier if you have it professionally cleaned out regularly. Next, I'm going to show you why cotton swabs like Q-tips are never recommended for cleaning out your ear canals. This dark area is dried blood in an ear canal after my patient scraped her ear canal with a cotton swab. Ultimately, she is lucky she didn't puncture a hole inside of her eardrum. This just goes to show how dangerous cotton swabs can be if you disregard the warning clearly printed on the packaging to never insert the swab into an ear canal. It is also the precise reason why you should never stick anything inside of your ears. This patient got lucky by only causing an abrasion and some bleeding in her ear. Next, we have another cotton swab attack, and this individual wasn't quite as lucky. You can clearly see that there is a hole inside of this individual's eardrum. Ear canals are not very deep, and the eardrum is only made up of three layers of skin, which means that it doesn't take a whole lot to cause a lot of damage. A hole like this is so large that it would likely require surgery in order to close it. Up next, we have a case of otitis externa, which is otherwise known as an outer ear infection. This patient reported an itching sensation and pain in her right ear. This is an image of her ear canal after only 2 days on her antibiotics to treat the infection. You can see how swollen it is and how narrow it made the ear canal. The whitish material is part of the infected fluid in the canal. I was able to suction a lot of this material out of her ear, and after the antibiotics did their job, her ear canal returned to normal. Now we have an example of a foreign object stuck inside of someone's ear canal. Every once in a while, a patient will come in wondering why their hearing aids are not fitting inside of their ears as well as usual. In some cases, this is earwax buildup, and in other cases, a hearing aid dome pops off inside of their ear canal. While this may seem like an emergency, hearing aid domes are typically easy to remove without complication. And last but not least, we have a cholesteatoma and another little surprise that I'll show you once we're inside of the ear canal. Now, a cholesteatoma is a non-cancerous growth that typically occurs inside of the middle ear space, and it can often obstruct the eardrum or damage a lot of the structures inside of the middle ear space. If left untreated, it can cause a lot of middle ear infections and a lot of drainage, and it can even negatively impact your hearing. This particular patient has had two surgeries to remove a cholesteatoma that keeps coming back, and it is likely that a third one is starting to form. Cholesteatomas typically appear as a whitish mass that forms behind the eardrum. You can clearly see that this is not a typical eardrum. You can see what appears to be scar tissue and possibly another cholesteatoma forming. There is also some earwax towards the top of his eardrum, and the little surprise on the left-hand side of his eardrum is a green pressure equalization tube. This is common to see with individuals who are prone to middle ear infections. An eardrum like this can most definitely lead to a conductive hearing loss because it does not transfer sound effectively through the middle ear space on its way to the inner ear. Every time you look into an ear canal, you never really know what you're going to find. And it is that anticipation that makes otoscopy one of the most exciting parts of being an audiologist. So the next time your hearing care professional takes a look inside of your ear canals, ask them if they have a video otoscope like the Aurical Otocam 300 so you can join in on the fun as well. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you like the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.